All Scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. 2 Timothy 3:16.
The Bible inspired by God? This was a bit of a stretch for me. I was pretty skeptical about that. I mean, how could men writing a book be inspired? But as I got reading the Old Testament and the New Testament together, you realize that these men wrote it over a period of hundreds of years, 1,500 years or more, and yet it all seemed to fit together. There was prophecy actually made about events hundreds of years in the future, about Jesus' life and his death and resurrection that came true. So for me, the Bible interprets itself, and there's no way that it could have done that if God had not intervened and inspired this book.
Thy word is true from the beginning, and every one of thy righteous judgments endureth forever. Psalms 119, verse 160.
Of course, the Bible did seem to have some little inconsistencies, but once I started to study deeper, I soon realized that the Bible really didn't contradict itself at all. All of these contradictions seemed to melt away. In fact, the Bible seemed to confirm and support itself.
You alone are the Lord. You made heaven, the heaven of heavens, with all their host, the earth and all things on it, the seas and all that is in them, and you preserve them all. Nehemiah 9:6.
Still, I wondered if the Bible had been altered over the years. I mean, how could a book so old, a book handled by so many different men and translated different times, really maintain its original accuracy? Then I heard about the Dead Sea Scrolls. Bible scrolls preserved in a cave for over 2,000 years. When these scrolls were compared to the modern translations, they found no major differences. The meaning of the original texts were about the same. It seems that God has preserved the writings.
But he answered and said to them, I tell you that if these should keep silent, the stones would immediately cry out. The scripture cannot be broken. Luke 19:20, John 10:35.
I decided to put the Bible to an objective test. I wanted to see, is the Bible historically accurate? I wanted to see how the Bible account matches up with historic fact. So I did some research on the internet. I typed in, does archaeology prove the Bible? I found some interesting things. Skeptics said things like, the Bible is false because it mentions this vast Hittite nation that never even existed. They said King Nebuchadnezzar never existed. They even said King David was only a mythic, heroic figure that never existed. Until one day, some archaeologists were poking around the Middle East, and they found the ruins of a city. It was a city of the Hittite nation. Other archaeologists found things like the Cyrus cylinder and the Moabite stone. As a matter of fact, one year after a man had written an entire book about how King David was only a mythical heroic figure, they found records to prove that King David did in fact exist. You see, outside of the Bible, there were no other documents to prove that these people existed. So what skeptics had done is they had judged the Bible guilty until proven innocent. Time and time again, the Bible has been proven accurate. But Jesus was right when he said, if we don't cry out, even the stones will cry out.
I am God, and there is none like me, declaring the end from the beginning, and from ancient times things that are not yet done. Isaiah 46:9-10.